doctors say you're no good. But people say what they wanna say. And you should know it's for good. I breathe in every single day. Hey guys, so I already have my foundation set and I already did my eyebrow. But everything else, I'm just going to be showing it to you guys. So let's just get started. Today's baby of the day or of the tutorial is going to be the new Too Faced Chocolate Bonbons palette. I'm so excited that I really did get this, you guys. And there's already going to be a review on it and an unboxing just because I did get two palettes from them. And so yeah, we're gonna link that down in the description box. So let's just get started, you guys. Today I already have some tape here just so I have a perfect line with my eyeshadow, you guys. And yeah, so we're just gonna get right into this baby. But first we're gonna prime our eyes, and what I'm using is the e.l.f. primer. I really do need to go get a different one, but for now this is what I have. So some primer is better than no primer. At least that's what I think. Let me know, you guys, in the comment section below, which primer do you think is best? Which one has worked best for you? I just want some tips, some ideas, and on which one I should be getting. Okay, guys. So using my Style Master brush, this is a really thin brush. It's like a really, I just love the consistency of this brush. I'm going to be going in with Almond Truffle right here. And I'm just going to apply that all over my crease. This is going to be my transition color. It is truly, oh my god. I have never owned a palette like this. This is literally my first high-end palette, and let me tell you one thing. I know why it's high-end. With just the first application. Next thing I'm going to be taking Café de lait, which is coffee milk in French. Café au lait, I'm sorry. And I'm just going to be applying that on my lid. So this is how it looks so far. Next thing I'm taking is I'm going a little bit out of the box, you guys, and using another brush. Here I'm using this one right here. It's like a blending brush, sort of. I'm going to be taking Totally Fetch. It's such a beautiful hot pink, you guys. I hope you could really see that. It's like, it's an amazing hot pink color. And I'm just going to take a little bit of that, just a little dab, that's all you need. And I'm just gonna get it right in the center of the lid. Oh my god, I love it. I was like, for my first look with this palette, I have to go like bold or go home. Not too bold, I mean, I just have to like go like, I have to use the pink color that's in here. This is honestly, you guys, the color that attracted me to this palette. I thought they were totally like, you know, taking it a little further out with this color. You don't really see a lot of palettes like that have this color. It's so beautiful. It's stunning, you guys. I absolutely adore the way this is looking so far. Now, I do like shimmery, and for this makeup tutorial I am doing shimmery, so I'm gonna go ahead and take Black Currant, which is a beautiful amethyst color, as you can see here. It's totally amazing. Like, I hope you can see this. It's beautiful. It has so much glitter actually, And I'm just going to take a dab of that. And I'm just going to do it on my outer crease. On the outer part of my lid. Gonna go right ahead and dab some of that on. Oh my god, it's beautiful, you guys. This black amethyst is really, really, really the way to go. God, it's so beautiful. Next, I'm going in with the first brush that I started with. And I'm just going to be taking some Bordeaux. I think that's how you pronounce it. Something like this color right here. It's like a brown hot chocolate color. It's quite pigmented. And I'm just going to apply that in the outer part of my crease. And on the angle right here. Like the V shape, right? The V shape of our eye. I'm just going to take it in quite in, almost to the center of my eye. God, it's so beautiful. And I'm just going to go back with my other brush and I'm going to take some of the black currant again. Just so it can like reappear and not be out of the picture. There is a little bit of fallout with this eye palette, but it's nothing too crazy. God, it's beautiful. I'm actually going to go ahead and I'm not scared about this. So I'm going to go and add a little bit more of Totally Fetch right on the middle. I feel like this color totally works. So many people I've seen have been quite scared to touch this color. But to me, it's just like one of my favorites. So this is how it's looking so far. Next thing I'm doing is I'm going to take a clean brush. This is like a blending brush, and I'm gonna take a little bit of Divinity just because I do have a lot of shimmer already. So I'm just gonna take some Divinity right here. It's a beautiful matte nude color. It's just perfect to highlight your brow. And so I'm just gonna do that. Oh my god, you guys, these colors show up so good. Divinity is what I'm looking like. I'm looking divine. Oh my god, that was so corny, but I just went there. Now, just gonna like tap this brush off. And next thing that I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna blend everything in, you guys. That is the most important part of this look. Blending everything all out. You just gotta be patient with the blending. Definitely, like, just go, like, gentle. They blend out really, really nicely, you guys. I'm totally loving this palette so far. The colors, they're popping. I actually want the pink to be a little bit more pigmented. So I'm just gonna take the brush that I applied it with. I'm going to spray a little bit of this Tony Moly Pocket Bunny right on it. And that basically just makes it a little bit wet. And I'm just going to take some of that Totally Fetch and I'm going to apply it right up in there. in the center, like I was already doing. And as you can see, that totally made it pop a lot more. This is like so perfect. We're just gonna go back in and blend for like a date night on Valentine's Day. Oh my god. Loving this so much. And I actually do want a little bit more Bordeaux on my outer crease, so I'm just gonna go ahead and do that. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. And so far, I really do love it. I'm just gonna go ahead and take the tape off. Ooh, look at that cut. Oh my god, I'm totally dying in love with this. It's so beautiful. Oh my god, you guys, I can't believe I did this. One of my best looks, if not the best up to date, you guys. Oh my god, I love it. I love it. I definitely feel like I cut the crease here a little bit too short. Yeah, this one is definitely like, so I'm just gonna go in with a little bit of Bordeaux. I'm totally smelling the chocolate. It is addicting. I'm about to go get me some chocolate. Oh, so beautiful, so beautiful. Lastly, you guys, we do need one more thing. I'm gonna go ahead and take a little bit of molasses chip. It's a beautiful, beautiful golden brown color. And I'm gonna take a little bit of that and just apply it under my bottom line. Molasses chip. I really do love the name that they gave this color. I don't know why. I love it. Molasses chip. And I'm just gonna pull this a little bit outward right here. The molasses chip, I mean. Which is barely going to be noticeable because I'm going to go ahead and line that right after. But yeah. Molasses chip, you guys. Molasses, asses, ass. Whoa. I just realized how bad that sounded. So next thing I'm doing is I'm taking my Stila eyeliner. This is black, really black. I love it. It doesn't like run on me, which is one of my favorite things about it. And I'm just going to go ahead and line my waterline. I love it. I would totally go ahead and add a little bit of glitter just to make it pop a little bit more. Like it's not popping enough already. So I'm going to take a clean brush and I'm just going to take a little bit of satin sheet, which is this beautiful, beautiful color right here. It's also like a nude, like to highlight. It's a highlighter color kind of. So I'm just going to take a little bit of this and just put it on my inner corner of my eyes just to make my eyes brighter. And shimmery and beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. I love this pink. It's so beautiful, you guys. Next thing, you guys, I've been trying to think about what color I want for my lips. And I don't think I want it too pink or too red, too berry. So I'm going to take this Luster Matte Longwear Lip Color from Sephora. I'm loving this brand, these lipsticks, and this is in a mulberry luster, you guys, just so you can see it. It's extremely beautiful, and I'm just gonna take that. I'm gonna apply it to my lips. Truly beautiful, truly, truly, truly beautiful. This is definitely one of the bolder looks. This is definitely a more bolder look for Valentine's Day, definitely. Now, off camera, I'm just gonna go ahead and do my eyeliner, a thick eyeliner, and I'm just gonna like conceal my lips on the outer parts just so you could cover up any little like mistakes that you have. So I'll be right back with you guys. Next thing I'm gonna do is take my e.l.f. complexion brush, and I'm just gonna add a little bit of a bronzer. The bronzer that I am using is also an e.l.f. It's from the e.l.f. contour palette, and I'm just gonna contour a little. I don't want anything too deep. It's just ever so slight. As you can see, I'm not going for anything bold with the bronzer today. And next, I'm just gonna use my small e.l.f. stipple brush. And I'm gonna use this e.l.f. baked blush. I'm just gonna dab some right on there. And I'm just gonna apply some on the cheeks. I love this blush just because it's not strong. And for me, I'm personally new at this whole blush thing. So I do tend to go a little bit overboard. So what I like this big palette just because it's not strong enough. So I can actually go ahead and apply a little more with like a not easy hand and it'll be okay. I'm not worried that I'm gonna get like some like crazy, like, you know, cheeks. So I'm just gonna use my Style Master blush now that I already kind of have what I want, and I'm just gonna apply that. I hope you can see it. It's a beautiful color, you guys. It's really cute. It has some shimmer. It's perfect for Valentine's Day as well. Oh my god. Oh my god. Okay. And finally, the last thing that I'm going to do is I'm just going to take a little bit of satin sheets as well right here. And I'm going to put that on my brush. And I'm just going to highlight with this. Oh my god, you guys. Oh. Such a beautiful highlight, such a beautiful highlight. And I'm just gonna blend it all in with my e.l.f. complexion brush. Ooh, that satin sheets, oh my god, it's like a perfect highlighter. Oh god, it's beautiful. I'm gonna take a little bit of this satin sheets again with a clean brush, and I'm just gonna do the top of my nose, my nose bridge. I'm not going crazy today. I'm not gonna like contour my nose and stuff, but I am gonna kind of highlight it. God, it's beautiful. Oh my god. Gonna go ahead and do my little area right here. Why did I just forget what it's called? The bridge of my lips. And now, oh my god, I think I'm beautiful. I think I'm ready to go on a date. Let's leave our hair loose, you guys. What I used to do my brows was a Maybelline Brow Precise in a color brown. I love it. It's made in Mexico, you guys. How cool is that? Yeah, I've gone to Mexico and I hardly see any of like Maybelline there, which is kind of weird. God, you guys, isn't this beautiful? Oh my god. I'm so in love with this look. Oh my god. And if my hubby wants to kiss me and I smell like chocolate, isn't it even more better? God, it's so beautiful. Definitely, definitely do recommend this palette. Make sure you go out and get your hands on one of these beautiful babies. It's so beautiful. I forgot the most important part, my mascara. I forgot to curl my eyelashes. That's just crazy. Oh my god, I forgot to curl my eyelashes. Oh my god, guys. Totally not smart. Don't forget to curl your eyelashes for your date. I'm taking my Better Than Sex mascara for from Too Faced, and I'm just gonna apply it. It's beautiful. I'm not a fan of fake lashes, you guys. From my opinion, a lot of guys don't really like them. I don't know. I don't even do it for the guys. I just don't like to do it, period. At least my lashes, I want to be natural. Even though I got like the shortest, most, like, non-existent lashes. A gift for your, I don't know, your mom if she likes makeup, your sisters. If you're a guy looking at this video, when you want it for your girlfriend, you should totally get her this for Valentine's Day and wrap it up in some like garland or tissue paper. So beautiful, you guys. It's the perfect present. Oh my god, I'm so in love with it. Thank you, bae. It was a gift for my baby, so I'm so happy about that. Make sure that if you love this tutorial, give it a big, big, big thumbs up, you guys. And definitely make sure to give it a big thumbs up. It really helps a girl out, you guys. And just thank you so much for watching this video tutorial with me. I hope you do really, really love it as much as I did. And yeah, thank you so much, you guys. Hope to see you in my next video. If you're not already, make sure to click the subscribe button down below. Or right here if you're in your PC, you guys. So thank you so much. See you in the next video.